this day, and save our souls, O blessed one.
Trust in the Lord, and through the mercy of those by thee shall not be moved. because of my sin. and bow down greatly. I go, mourning all the day long, for my lungs are full of inflammation, and there is no soundness in my flesh. I am feeble and severely broken. I groan because of the turmoil of heart. Lord, all my desire is before you, and my sign is not hidden from you. My heart pains, my strength fails me. As for the light of my eyes, it also has gone from me. My loved ones and my friends stand aloof from my place, and my relatives stand afar off. Those also who seek my life lay snares for me. Those who seek my heart speak of destruction and plan deception all the day long. But I, like a deaf man, do not hear, and I am like a mute who does not open his mouth. Thus I am like a man who does not hear, and in whose mouth there is no response. For in you, O Lord, I hope you will hear, O Lord my God. For I said, hear me, lest they rejoice over me, lest when my foot slips they exalt themselves against me. For I am ready to fall, and my sorrow is continually before me. For I will declare my iniquities. I will be in anguish over my sin. But my enemies are vigorous, and they are strong. And those who hate me wrongfully have multiplied. Those also who render evil for good, they are my adversaries, because I follow what is good. Do not forsake me, O Lord. O my God, be not far from me. Make haste to answer me, O Lord, my salvation. Do not forsake me, O Lord. O my God, be not far from me. Make haste to help me, O Lord, my salvation. O God, you are my God. Early will I seek you. My soul thirsts for you. My flesh longs for you in a dry and thirsty land where there is no water. So I have looked for you in the sanctuary to see your power and your glory. Because your loving kindness is better than life, my lips shall praise you. Thus I will bless you while I live. I will lift up my hands in your name. My soul be satisfied as with marrow and fatness, and my mouth shall praise you with joyful lips. When I remember you on my bed, I meditate on you in the night watches. Because you have been my help, therefore in the shadow of your wings I will rejoice. My soul follows close behind me. Your right hand upholds me, but those who seek my life to destroy shall go into the lower parts of the earth. They shall fall by the sword. They shall be a portion for jackals, but the king shall rejoice in God. Everyone who swears by him shall glory, but the mouth of those who speak lies shall be stopped. I meditate on you in the night watches, because you have been my help. Therefore, in the shadows of your wings I will rejoice. My soul follows close behind me. Your right hand upholds me. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 doxa sui teos. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Doxa patrinte iombe, iombe, patrinte iombe, Jesus aones, pone aones. Amen. O Lord God of my salvation, I cry out day and night before you, that my prayer come before you. Incline your ear to my cry, for my soul is full of troubles, and my life draws near to the grave. I am counted with those who are down to the pit. I am like a man who has no strength. I drift among the dead, like a slain who lie in the grave, whom you remember no more, and who are cut off from your hand. You have laid me in the lowest pit, in darkness and death. Your arrow lies heavy upon me, and you have afflicted me with all your ways. You have put away all my iniquities far from me. You have made me an abomination to them. I am shut up, and I cannot get out. My eyes wasted away because of affliction. Lord, I have called daily upon you. I have straightened out my hands to you. Will you work wonders for the dead? Shall the dead arise and praise you? Shall your love and kindness be declared in the grave, or your faithfulness in a place of destruction? Shall your wonders be known in the dark, and your righteousness in the land of forgetfulness? But to you I cried out, O Lord, and in the morning my prayer comes before you. Lord, why do you cast off my soul? Why do you hide your face from me? I have been afflicted and ready to die for my youth. I suffer your terrors. and destructed. Your fierce wrath had gone over me. Your terrors cut me off. They came around me all day long like water. They engulfed me altogether. Loved one and friend, you have put far from me, and my acquaintance into darkness. O Lord, God of my salvation, I have cried out day and night before you, that my prayer come before you. Incline your ear to my cry. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who forgives all your iniquities, who heals all your diseases, who redeems your life from destruction, who grounds you with loving kindness and tender mercies, who satisfies your mouth with good things so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. The Lord excuses righteousness and justice for all who oppose. He made known his ways to Moses, his act to the children of Israel. The Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger and abounding in mercy. He will not always strike with us, nor will he keep his anger forever. He has not dealt with us according to our sins, nor punished us according to our iniquities. For as the heavens are high above the earth, so great is his mercy towards those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far as he removed the transgressions from us. As a father pities his children, so the Lord pities those who fear him. For he knows our frame, he remembers that we are dust. As for man, his days are like grass. As a flower of the field, so shall he flourish. For the wind passes over it, and is gone, and his place remembers no more. But the mercy of the Lord is everlasting, to everlasting on those who fear him. And his righteousness to children, to such as keep his covenant, and to those who remember his commandments to do them. The Lord has established his throne in heaven, and his kingdom rules over all. Bless the Lord and his angels, who exalt his reign, who do his word, healing the voice of his word. Bless the Lord, all of his host, who ministries to his, who do his pleasure. Bless the Lord, all his works in all places of his dominion. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Bless the Lord, O my soul, in all places of his dominion. Hear my prayer, O Lord. Give ear to my supplication in your faithfulness. Answer me in your righteousness. Do not enter into judgment with your servant. For your sight, no one living is righteous. For the enemy has persecuted my soul. He has crushed my life to the ground. He has made me dwell in darkness like those who have long been dead. Therefore, my spirit is overwhelmed within me. My heart within me is distressed. I remember the days of old. I meditate on all your works. I muse on the works of your hands. I spread out my hands to you. My soul longs for you like a thirsty land. Answer me speedily, O Lord. My spirit fails. Do not hide your face from me, lest I be like those who go down to the pit. Cause me to hear your love kindness in the morning, for in you do I trust. Cause me to know the way in which I should walk, for I lift up my soul to you. Deliver me, O Lord, from my enemies. In you I get shelter. Teach me to do your will, for you are my God. Your spirit is good. Lead me in the land of unrighteousness. Revive me, O Lord, for your name's sake. For your righteousness, say, bring my soul out of trouble, and your mercy cut off my enemies, and destroy all those who afflict my soul, for I am your servant. In your righteousness, O Lord, answer me, and enter not into judgment with your servant. Your spirit is good, lead me in the land of righteousness. Amen. Alleluia, 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 doxa sa Deus. Alleluia, 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 doxa sa Deus. Alleluia, 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 glory to you, O God. E a peace in one year, doxa sa Deus.
Thank you. At that time the crowd that had been with him when he called Lazarus out of the tomb and raised him from the dead bore witness. The reason why the crowd went to meet him was that they heard he had done this sign. The Pharisees then said to one another, "You see that you can do nothing. Look, the world has gone after him." Now among those who went up to worship at the feast were some Greeks. So these came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee, and said to him, "Sir, we wish to see Jesus." Philip went and told Andrew. Andrew went and with Philip, and they told Jesus. And Jesus answered them, "The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Truly, truly, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains alone. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. He who loves his life loses it, and he who hates his life in this world will keep it for eternal life. If anyone serves me, he must follow me, and where I am, there shall my servant be also. If anyone serves me, the Father will honor him. Now is my soul troubled, and what shall I say? Father, save me from this hour. No, for this purpose I have come to this hour. Father, glorify your name." Then a voice from heaven came, "I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again." The crowd standing by heard it and said that it had thundered. Others said an angel has spoken to him. Jesus answered, "This voice has come for your sake, not for mine. Now is the judgment of this world. Now shall the ruler of this world be cast out. And I, when I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all men to myself." He said this to show by what death he was to die. The crowd answered him, "We have heard from the law that the Christ remains forever. How can you say that the Son of Man must be lifted up? Who is this Son of Man?" Jesus said to them, "The light is with you for a little longer. Walk while you have the light, lest the darkness overtake you. He who walks in the darkness does not know where he goes. While you have the light, believe in the light, that you may become sons of light." When Jesus had said this, he departed and hid himself from them. Though he had done so many signs before them, yet they did not believe in him. It was that the word spoken by the prophet Isaiah might be fulfilled, "Lord, who has believed our report, and to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed?" Therefore they could not believe. For Isaiah again said, "He has blinded their eyes and hardened their heart, lest they should see with their eyes, and perceive with their heart, and turn for me to heal them." Isaiah said this because he saw his glory and spoke of him. Nevertheless, many even of the authorities believed in him, but for fear of the Pharisees, they did not confess it, lest they should be put out of the synagogue. For they loved the praise of men more than the praise of God. And Jesus cried out and said, "He who believes in me believes not in me, but in him who sent me. And he who sees me sees him who sent me. I have come as light into the world, that whoever believes in me may not breathe. The word that I have spoken will be his judge on the last day. For I have not spoken of my own authority. The Father who sent me has himself given me commandment what to say and what to speak. And I know that his commandment is eternal.
στο όνομα του Πατρός και του Υιού και του Αγίου Πνεύματος. Αμήν. Τι αναζητάμε σε αυτή τη ζωή? Σωτηρία, λύτρωση, ιδού ο νυμφίος. Σήμερα θα ψάλουμε ένα από τους αγαπημένους μου ύμνους. Ναι, ο ύμνος της Αγίας Κασιανής είναι πανέμορφος, αλλά αναφέρομαι σε άλλον ύμνο. Και σε αυτόν τον ύμνο έχουμε ένα υπέροχο παράδειγμα και υπόδειγμα αγάπης και μετανοίας. Και εκδηλώνοντας εμείς αυτή την αγάπη, μπορούμε και εμείς να λάβουμε την λύτρωση, την σωτηρία μας, δια την χάρη του Θεού. Θα το διαβάσω πρώτα. Ο υμνογράφος μας δείχνει ένα πανέμορφο παραλληλισμό μεταξύ την καρδιά και την πράξη του Ιούδα και παράλληλα την καρδιά και την πράξη της αμαρτωλής. Ότε η αμαρτωλός προσέφερε το μύρον, τότε ο μαθητής συνεφώνει της παρανόμης. Ημέν έχερε καινούσα το πολύτιμον, ο δε έσπευδε πολύσε τον ατίμητον. Αύτη τον δεσπότην επεγίνωσχε, ούτως του δεσπότου εχωρίζετο. Αύτη ηλευθερούτο και ο Ιούδας δούλος εγεγόνη του εχθρού. Δεινών η ραθυμία, μεγάλη η μετάνοια. Ήν μη δώρησε σωτήρ, ο παθών υπερ ημών και σώσον μας. Δηλαδή λέει, όταν η αμαρτωλή προσέφερε το μύρο, την ίδια στιγμή ο μαθητής συμφωνεί με τους παρανόμους. Η αμαρτωλή χαιρότανε να διάσει το πολύτιμο μύρο, ο άλλος γρήγορα πήγε να πουλήσει αυτόν, που έχει ανεκτίμητη αξία. Εκείνη έτσι γνώρισε τον δεσπότη και ο Ιούδας έτσι διαχωρίστηκε από τον δεσπότη Κύριο. Αυτή απελευθερώθηκε και ο Ιούδας έγινε δούλος του εχθρού. Πόσο φοβερή είναι η ραθυμία του, πόσο μεγάλη είναι η μετάνοια της αμαρτωλής. Αυτή την μετάνοια να μας δωρήσει σωτήρα, αυτός που υπέφερε για μας, σώσε μας. Ορίστε αγαπητοί μου αδερφοί, η μετάνοια και η αγάπη μας προς τον Χριστό μας, τι καλύτερο μάθημα για παράδειγμα θέλουμε. Ας ακολουθήσουμε τα βήματα της αμαρτωλής και όχι τα βήματα του Ιούδα. Ας ακολουθήσουμε τα βήματα της αγάπης και της μετανοίας και όχι τα βήματα της Εύας που θα ακούσουμε στον ύμνο της Κασιανής. Ας γεμίσουμε τα λιχνάρια των ψυχών μας για να υποδεχτούμε τον νυμφίο Χριστό. Μόνο Αυτός μας χαρίζει λύτρωση και σωτηρία. Ελπίζω να έχουμε κουράγιο και ο Θεός να μας δίνει δύναμη να προχωρήσουμε με το σταυρό μας που μερικές φορές νιώθει ασήκωτος. Αμήν. What do we want in this life? Are we looking for salvation? Do we want redemption? Behold the Bridegroom. Today we will chant one of my favorite hymns. Yes, the hymn of Kasyani is beautiful, but I'm referring to another hymn. And in this hymn, we have a beautiful example and act of love and repentance. And when we practice this love, we too can attain salvation and redemption through the grace of God. The hymnographer here illustrates two parallel paths between the heart and intention and act of Judas, and simultaneously the heart intention, an act of the sinful woman. The hymn goes, while the sinful woman was offering the myrrh, the disciple was making terms with the lawless. She rejoiced in emptying out that which was precious. He hastened to sell him who was above all price. She acknowledged the master. Acknowledged is a very weak translation here. Epeginosken means to understand. It means to be intimate with. Understanding goes with the word diania. When Jesus said, love the Lord with all your mind, and soul, and being, understanding, epeginoske, she knew the Master. He severed himself from the Master. She was set free, and Judas became a slave to the enemy. Monstrous was his callousness, scary, horrid, is his indolence, his sloth. Great was her repentance. Grant me this also, O Savior, who suffered for us and saved us. And there it is, my beloved, repentance and our love for Christ. What better lesson and message are we looking for? Let us follow then in the footsteps of the sinful woman and not in the footsteps of Judas. Let us follow in the footsteps of love and repentance, and not in the footsteps of Eve, which we will hear about in the hymn of Cassianini. Let us fill our vigil lamps, the vigil lamps of our souls, so that we may receive our Bridegroom Christ. Only he grants us salvation and redemption and healing. I wish us all courage and good strength this week and our whole lives. Amen.
Amen.
With the Lord. To the Lord.
Lord, have mercy. Savior, deliver me from the mire of my knees. Kiddushin, 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 kiddushin. Those that think you, you think you, but you think you, you think you, you think you, you think you, you
venerate the Theos icon for the last time for the year.